Well, we seem to hear the same thing every year. This year is projected to be the worst allergy season ever. Now, that may sound familiar, but did you know it could have an impact on your heart as well? So what's the link, and why does allergy season seem to always be at its worst? We are joined by cardiologist Dr. Stephen Sinatra to answer those questions and much more for us this morning. Good morning to you, Dr. Sinatra. Nice to have you on. This is a topic a lot of people want to know about because we're dealing with allergies right now. Why does it seem like allergy season is always bad, and it even feels as if it's not just a season anymore, but year round?
Well, it gets worse. You know, the problem with allergies is once you have one allergy, you can develop another allergy because the immune system gets sensitized. It's almost like a horse's tail, Sylvia. In other words, if you're allergic to one thing, a tail has all these hairs in it, and it expands and expands. So a person can have a food allergy, then a pollen allergy, and then an allergy to a pharmaceutical medication, and the list goes on and on and on. But allergies you have to take seriously because it causes inflammation, and inflammation can affect the heart. And as a cardiologist, I'm really privy to that situation because I've seen lots of heart disease induced by inflammatory disorders.
So that's really interesting because that is not something we would normally think about, but it makes sense because we all know inflammation is so bad for our health in so many ways and can result in so many other problems. So taking allergy medications constantly is something a lot of people do, or they get regular allergy shots. And I understand you have five ways to calm our allergies naturally. So let's start with the first one. You say there are certain foods such as red apples, bell peppers, pineapples, sardines, strawberries, almonds that can help. How so?
Well, red apples contain quercetin. Quercetin is a bioflavonoid, and basically you can take it as a supplement as well. But quercetin has a remarkable effect. It actually calms down the immune system, and it really supports the body in so many ways. In fact, it's an incredible anti-aging supplement. And again, as a nutritional bioflavonoid. Now, apples and black tea. This is a great time for people to switch from coffee to tea because coffee can make the allergy worse, but tea contains quercetin, black tea, as well as green apples. And quercetin is amazing, especially during COVID-19 as well, because quercetin will rebuttal any inflammatory situation, especially viral prodromes as well, like a COVID-19 virus.
Okay, so quercetin, you also say specific supplements, other ones including vitamin D, NAC, which I'm not sure if I know what that is.
Oh, NAC, I love it, Sylvia. NAC is N-acetylcysteine. And it's broken down in the body to glutathione. And basically, if you take vitamin C and selenium, you form this incredible antioxidant, immune-enhancing, we call it glutathione peroxidase. And this is awesome. So anybody can get NAC in a health food store, N-acetylcysteine. I love it. It's one of my go-to supplements.
Okay. We have a minute left, and I want to go through all these because I think they're so great. Let's go to the neti pot next, which kind of came to be well-known to people a few years ago, but it's still interesting to always see how this works. Why can the neti pot on a daily basis make a difference now?
Yeah, basically, if your mucous membranes have become inflamed and you're all clogged up and you have mucus discharge, by irrigating the nose, you know, one nostril at a time with a neti pot, this is awesome because you cleanse the nostril. I would also recommend taking a shower at night and washing your hair and getting the pollen off your hair. If you get the pollen off your hair and your face and you cleanse the nose, you're going to sleep a lot better that night because the allergen will be dissipated.
Okay, acupuncture is the next one on your list, but I want to go to this last one because this is something I'm not familiar with, and that's earthing and meditation. Walking on the beach or other grass, barefoot, yoga mats, music, prayer, journaling. I would never think that that would lead to me having, you know, fewer allergy issues. Explain especially this whole earthing thing.
Well, the earthing is the most important thing you can do. I've written a book on earthing. I've done so much research on earthing over the last 15 years. And what it does, Sylvia, it attenuates an overactive sympathetic nervous system. In other words, it balances the parasympathetic with the sympathetic. It eases down emotional stress, and that's the important thing. It helps to lower cortisol, you know, an inflammatory hormone. It lowers adrenaline. Earthing is the best thing you can do, and it's free. You can just walk outside. You know, I was watching your program, and people are going to the beach now, and if you walk outside on sand or rock or concrete or grass, you want to take in Mother Earth energy, and Mother Earth energy, we call it the Schumann Resonance, is amazing anti-inflammatory. Absolutely
really?
Love it.
Oh, who knew? So I am going to take off my boots today. I'm going to walk on the grass or walk on the sand, and that's going to help me out. Who knew? I'm sure a lot of people are familiar with this. I didn't know, but I'm definitely going to do this now that I've spoken to you. Okay, where can people go to learn more about you, read your books, and get all the great information you just shared?
Oh, they can go to drsinatra.com or vervana.com. You know, heartmdinstitute.com. There's so many different websites I have. And,
awesome.
There's a lot of good information.
Well, it was a pleasure to talk to you. Please come back and visit us.
Thank you, Sylvia.
Okay, have a good day. Coming up on...